Overflowing landfills, plastic oceans, climate change, it can seem overwhelming. How on earth can we individually make any difference? Well, this year I decided to try living zero waste. For devotees, this means no plastic, no paper, no food waste. Some say they can fit 5 years of rubbish into one jar. But I needed help, so I found some passionate guides. Are their efforts just for the planet, or did they, like me, find something else? So it's the 1st of January 2019. It's also day one of my zero waste challenge.
I was so naive, so determined.
What do you do about tooth floss? Because we know that that causes issues in the environment.
And before I knew it, I was on the zero waste waka.
Had some advice last night about what to do about mosquitoes.
Avoiding plastic bottles of bug spray.
Put a fan in the room because apparently mosquitoes don't like moving air. Easy, simple, non-toxic.
Fuming over how we package our food.
Each one is wrapped in plastic. Inside plastic. No!
And after a month, I found I couldn't stop. I'd been inspired. Not least by these two. Liam and Hannah live a nomadic lifestyle on a waste-free budget of just $20 a day.
A rubbish bin is not a magic delete machine, because the rubbish is still there and it's still got to go somewhere.
The superstars of the Kiwi Zero Waste movement.
From our planet's point of view, there's no throwing rubbish out because there is no out.
Their free talks pull crowds from around the country, all of them aiming to create less rubbish.
We want to leave the earth in a habitable state for our children and our children's children.
Yep, rosemary, and then after that we should get some basil.
4 years ago, as a young professional couple, Hannah and Liam made the life-changing decision to go zero waste.
Hey, Liam,
to the max.
Oh, yeah.
Sweet, thank you.
Since we started living without a rubbish bin, we've been keeping track of how much we have produced, and it's come out to 7.1 kilos.
What?
In that time, an average New Zealand couple would produce between a tonne to a tonne and a half of curbside household rubbish.
Wow.
You often hear things like individuals cannot make a difference, but there's quite a big difference between 7.1 kg and a tonne or a tonne and a half. And
that's just unbelievable.
So I'm producing over 200 times more rubbish than them.
It's blooming hard to go rubbish free or to be zero waste.
My early efforts were frustrating. Fail after fail.
Don't ever take your reusable cutlery on the airplane. I got my knife confiscated by security.
But there is a zero waste formula.
We forage a lot.
Liam and Hannah follow something called the waste hierarchy, or in lay speak, the six R's. That's refuse, replace, reduce, reuse, recycle, and rot.
So number one thing we do before anything else is we refuse what we do not need.
Do you reckon I should do a double batch of crackers?
Then we seek to replace things we do need that might be wasteful with a non-wasteful alternative.
And a bit of rosemary from the garden.
They replace packaged food with homemade kai.
Whatever we cannot refuse or replace, we just reduce our consumption of, so we get it less. People often say to us, what do you do about Tim Tams? So just have them less once a month instead of once a fortnight, and that is a legitimate, bona fide way to reduce waste. So you do not have to be a martyr or turn your life upside down for this.
And at this shop in Palmerston North,
stores like this are quite important because the sole purpose of the store is to reduce waste.
We see the fourth R in action, reuse. So, reusable jars and cloth bags.
A friend made this one for us.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Some fabric that she had found in a secondhand store.
Then there's recycling. Surprisingly low on the list.
We actually treat recycling as a waste stream to be reduced as well. We've been told for so long recycling is the answer, but it's not really, from a zero waste perspective.
Yep.
And after we've gone through all of this, everything we're left with, we should be able to rot in a home compost.
There we go.
So 5 months in, and I am doing some of those things. I've refilled, bottled, baked, harvested, and even tried sewing.
I just hope the stitches hold.
But some things I just can't do.
somebody said you need to check out the family cloth. So the real zealots don't use toilet paper. Instead, they use something called the family cloth. So here's an example. You would use one of these, throw it into a bin next to the toilet, wash it, and reuse it.
Exactly. And I was like, no!
You might be asking, what's the big deal? I mean, paper rots, right? Well, it's not just about the waste, the trees cut down. In fact, it's about the carbon footprint of everything. So how many fossil fuels went into the creation and shipping, for example, of this product?
And I'm still there with the no.
Yeah.
So, you know, discovering the family cloth was probably the darkest day of my zero waste journey.
I feel like some people will be resistant because they'll think, am I going to have to become a hippie? Will I have to do yoga? Will I have to plant a garden and run around naked?
Yeah.
Yes.
You can, yeah.
Right, OK. So that's all the thing.
We don't define zero waste. Nobody defines zero waste.
Yeah.
It's just a way of living, and you can make it your own. You can be budget and have fun. You can be chic and have a mason jar. You know, just whatever floats your boat.
Yeah.
It's all good.
Yeah.
But what if you have kids? How do you get your family across the line too? The Simmons McKinney blended whānau of five kids live Parokore, a Māori zero waste movement that first took root in Marae a decade ago.
To me, it's a way that we can operate as kaitiaki every day. We all are in a position to make some change.
Mum Shirley is Tauranga's Parokore coordinator.
For the boys who are now 8 and 9, they've kind of never really known any other way of life. So they've always grown up with a compost bin. We used to have pigs until recently, chickens, so that's where our food waste goes. Actually, they've never really known a rubbish bin.
I've brought my daughter Tererehua with me, hoping the boys will inspire her.
If people go to the shop and buy jars, they could like reuse it so the planet can't die.
Engari, ka mate tonu nga tueka.
The family is committed to taking only what they need. But when you look at all the glass, all the fancy ingredients, you can't help but wonder.
So how does anybody afford it, really? But you were doing this when you were a single mum.
Yeah, so if you're living waste-free, I think you're living more frugally.
Shirley's whānau grow their own food and make their own cleaning products. Today, it's soap.
So I get a lot of satisfaction out of the things that we do.
Okay.
The last maybe 3 years, we've been making our own soap. Yeah, we haven't bought soap for years.
Wow.
So we find now there's entire aisles of the supermarket that we just don't go down.
E te mihi ana, pihi o whakaaro mo te parakore.
Rawe?
Ai, rawe, kia ha ai.
Nā te mea ka whakaora I a pukatūnuku he kawate ao I mate.
Ai.
I guess finding things that a child's interested in. So we've kind of found things that the kids like to eat. You know, for example, Anika really likes cucumbers, so we chose seedlings, planted them and tended to them, and she harvested her cucumbers this summer. You're less likely to waste the food that you've grown yourself because you know what went into it.
Yeah.
You know, it was your time and your aroha.
Here's your cucumbers. Wow. Look at that. So you grew those cucumbers?
Yeah. Most of our salads come out of the garden. It's easier because you don't have to like rush to the store and grab everything.
You would never ever need to go to the shop. Hey, why go to the shop? What do you buy at the shop?
Rubbish.
Rubbish. That's classic. You're exactly right.
For Shirley and her whānau, it's about doing what you can.
Just sprinkle away.
Not worrying about what you can't.
Would you like to sprinkle some?
So, you know, I don't think that I can get rid of toilet paper.
We personally still use toilet paper, and we choose to use brands that package the toilet paper in compostable packaging. Zero waste doesn't necessarily eliminate all the time. Sometimes it's just use less of. If we were hand on heart honest with you, the most effective hours for cutting down waste are the refuse and reduce hours.
Marie Kondo cleanouts are all the rage.
keep only what makes you happy, and say thanks to each possession before throwing it out.
But what if we didn't buy all the stuff in the first place?
I'm so thrilled with my new vacuum. Look at this, it's got a built-in dustbuster. But the very best thing about this is it was free. Didn't cost me a cent. I went onto a free cycle site and I was offered this. So it's about moving from a throwaway culture to a giveaway, to a sharing culture.
The pesto took you, what, 10 minutes or something?
That is yum. Mm. But I still think that's my favourite, closely followed by that.
Some people see this as a sacrifice.
But actually, what we've discovered from living this lifestyle that's improved our life so much, we've saved lots of money, we eat more healthily, we're more creative. Yeah, we just love it.
I started this journey looking to do better for the planet. I didn't expect to find joy.
Sniff.
I'm loving doing this.
Don't say it out loud, bub.
It's created an unexpected and deeper connection to everything. And that gives me hope for our children and for the future.
If people are willing to take that step, they'll find the solutions are there.
And I hope you'll join me on this journey and we can help each other learn how to share this planet more mindfully together. It'll be neat.
Yes, so if you do want to join me on the Zero Waste journey, check out my Facebook or Instagram pages at Miriama Kamo. But after the program at 8:30, I'll be doing a Facebook Live on our Sunday TVNZ page, so we'll see you there.